Hello, my beautiful souls. Today I'm going to do something a little bit different. I want to do a generalized reading on how to heal from a broken relationship or divorce. Okay, so we're going to do oracle card reading today. Okay, I'm going to get these cards readied and shuffled. Okay, I really would like to do this. I love helping others, and I want to help these people that are experiencing this at this time. So we're going to go ahead and do a card reading for today. And this is just generalized. If it's not resonating with you, it's okay. These readings aren't for everyone. I just do them because I like to provide service for others. I just feel like I want to help someone. And if I even help one person with this video, that's great. If it does resonate with you, please like and subscribe. But again, we're asking Spirit, what do I need to do to heal from this broken relationship or from my divorce? Okay? Okay, now some of you, this might be hard to hear, but this has been a learning experience for you. So whether, you know, not everything that has happened during this time was bad. So you can always remember the good parts from it, but it is a learning experience. So the things that you didn't like that happened or ended up happening, you take note from that. But you will eventually be able to find another relationship. But the relationship that you need to currently work on right now is building that with yourself. Okay? Building a new relationship with yourself. Getting back to know who you are, what you like to do. Simple things. Remember who you are. Okay? Because life in general is a learning experience. And when we love somebody so much, you know, and then the relationship ends, it is very hard to get yourself back on track. And you've been with this person and been doing things with this person. And, you know, you do become one with this person. So now that this is ended, or you guys have separated at this time, you need to find time to get to know yourself better. You know, just don't sit there and mope on the couch. Start taking care of yourself. You know, dye your hair. You know, most of us women like to cut our hair after a relationship. You don't have to cut your hair, but do something different for yourself. You know, try some different makeup. Get some new outfits. Work on your wardrobe. What about going back painting? Or if you like jewelry, or if you like doing a certain kind of craft, or hang out with friends, or teaching others something. You know, this is a time for you to get back with what you used to do before you met them. Or things, move on to something that you learned during the relationship that you did like to do on your own. So start finding your passion again, okay? Yeah, it hurts, but you still gotta keep moving. We're all still here. The clock is still ticking. You still got, life still moves on. And I want you to know that your ancestors, you know that they're there. Your ancestors are there, your spirit guides are there. God is there, the universe is there, but you still, we all have a mission, a goal to complete in this body that we're in temporarily. So keep that in mind when you're going through this at this difficult time. And I'm sorry that you have to go through that experience. We've all experienced some kind of heartbreak or loss. But again, remember the good things which you can from that relationship, because nothing is promised forever. Okay? And then whatever that you did not like about it, you make sure that you look for those flags, you know, towards your next relationship, or just weed out the things that you don't like. Okay. So that's a helpful way to think of it to help you move on at this time, to help you heal. Another way to heal is you need to earth and ground. You need to get grounded. Okay, a good stone for being grounded I have in my shop is Tiger's Eye. Tiger Eye is a good stone for helping you to get grounded. You can walk outside, go to the beach, walk to the sand if you can, depending on what time of year it is, if you have that. And step outside, hug a tree if you can. Grow some trees or some vegetables. Get back in touch with nature. Sit in the sun. Okay, listen to some positive music, but you need to get grounded, okay? You need to put yourself in a positive space at this time. Don't sit there and listen to sad music all day. I'm going to tell you that right now. It's okay to hurt. You may play victim for like a few days, but you can't play victim forever. Okay? Be around friends who love you, that family that loves you, friends that love you, even acquaintances. Even if you move somewhere else, somebody out there loves you. Okay? Don't spend all your time alone moping around, but you do got to get grounded. Even if you need like a new animal or pet, maybe you need to do something, like find something else that you need to love that makes you get back into tune with yourself, okay, and with back into your world. Okay, it's about you at this time. Self-care. Another card I have is you got to trust in the universe, baby. Spirit's letting you know, God's letting you know, the angels letting you know, your ancestors, your spirit guides, they're all there. Trust, okay? You have to trust. Don't feel like you can't blame them for what happened. We are all humans and we all have free will. Again, even not making the choice, I can't stress this enough, is still making a choice. You have to trust in the relationship. If you want love again, you will get love again. But in the meanwhile, don't hop from relationship to relationship. I know that some people do like, I forgot what it's called when you meet somebody right after relationship. Don't do that. Just, you know, if you want to date and say, okay, I'm going to try and get back out there, go ahead and try and get back out there. But remember, do not focus on the other person. You focus on you. You do things when you want to do it because it is your time to heal. Work on you, okay? Because you can't love nobody else when your heart's broken over somebody else, okay? You got to heal yourself within. So right now, trust in the universe. If you are lost and feel misguided, pray about it, okay? Manifest on being happy. Work on being joy. Watch some movies on happiness. Go to comedy show. You know, hang with friends that are happy. You know, even if you have to join like a Facebook group on divorced wives that, or divorced husbands, divorced people, I don't know, but that are on a good positive vibe, not a sad vibe, but a good positive vibe, trying to get over the pain. So trust in the universe at this time. Okay, some of you, not all of you, some of you need to worry about cutting the cords. Now, this was a bad negative relationship that just completely drained you, and you did everything here, and they just, you know, straight up used you and took you to the ringer. Yeah, you might need to cut the cords here. That is hard. That is hard. But once you do finally decide to cut the cords with that person, you're going to realize how valuable you were, and they're going to miss you. You won't miss that person. Yeah, that might have been a person that you love so much. Yeah, at one point in time in your life, you would have did anything for them. But at the end, you were always the prize. They really needed you. You really didn't need them. You were golden, okay? You were always the prize. Your heart is gold. And for you to love somebody enough to carry both of you, how powerful is that? But sometimes you got to cut that cord because that energy is needed. How can you meet the next person who's going to value you if all the energy is going to that person still? And that person's not even there. That person didn't even give you 50%. They didn't even give you 20%. They only gave you 5% when they felt like it. And here you were giving 110, 150%. You deserve better. So think about cutting the cords, okay? Another way you might want to try healing is, well, the answer here is no. Okay, so something that somebody in this collective is thinking about, no, I don't think there was nothing that you could have done different. This was going to happen regardless, okay? And even if the relationship does decide to get back later, it was a growth period for both of you. So no, do not think it was you. You were not the problem, okay? Yes, it takes two in a relationship, but sometimes a door has to close for another one to open. Sometimes a door has to close because somebody didn't appreciate you for the treasure that you are. And sometimes doors closes for some of us that we didn't appreciate the treasure. So it can go both ways. Okay? But no, there was no other way that this was going to stop from happening. Okay? And I know that may not be the answer that you want to hear. And I hope this doesn't trigger anybody. So trigger warning here. But there was nothing that would have prevented this from happening. Okay, it was going to happen whether you wanted to or not. Okay, so I love you and I want you to heal. Okay, and that's why I'm doing this video. And these are just some messages from the angels that are letting you know that they want you to heal. You have everything you need to heal. We're humans and we're supposed to, we have all kinds of emotions, and there's nothing wrong with having emotions, okay? That's who we are. That's what makes us great. And sometimes emotions can be overwhelming, but you have to ask for guidance. You have to call on your angels if you need them help. They can't intervene if you don't ask them to help you. God is there. Your ancestors are there, okay? But you need to work on you at this time. Build that relationship back up with yourself. All right, and I'm going to do one more, okay? Listen deeply, okay? Listen deeply. If you have some real people, not the people who said, I told you so, I'm not talking about them. Listen deeply to the people who love you the most. And even if you feel... So, I hope this helped you. I'm sending prayers your way. I'm sending you love. I'm sending you light to get over this loss in your life right now. But I want to send you good vibes and strength and more self-love your way. And don't forget your affirmations. And if you feel that you would like a general reading on how to heal, I do have do general readings in my Etsy store. But if you feel that you want to message me on my email link below, let me know and I'll be more than happy to do so. Thank you so much. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And again, if this resonated with you, I really hope this helped. Thank you. Bye.